The slogan "Nothing for us without us" was the key driving force behind the idea of the UNDP Youth Sounding Board, an initiative by the UNDP and the Ministry of ICT and Youth Affairs.
Today we actually launched the UNDP Youth Sounding Board, and I am one of the co-chairs of this sounding board. So basically the UNDP Youth Sounding Board is a board that is supposed to bring approximately 17 board members together to sit down and spearhead UNDP's youth programs for development here in Kenya.
For us, our country program document for Kenya speaks to the youth agenda of this country. And we have seen way too often that decisions and allocations of resources and ideas are made on behalf of youth without youth being at the table where their views and their ideas must be taken into account. So we came up with the idea of a youth sounding board for UNDP in Kenya to ensure that not only do we create a seat at the table for youth, but we create an entire table for youth to sit on and to actually advise and guide and be in the kitchen with UNDP to tell us how our programs can be more responsive to the needs of youth, how our activities can be much more deliberate in addressing the youth needs, and to also ensure that nothing for youth is done without youth at the table.
The purpose is to involve the youth in matters that affect them in the aim of making a better and an all-inclusive future.
So the Youth Sounding Board is an all-inclusive, multi-sectoral platform of engagement that UNDP has designed to bring together influential youth voices to the table, to be able to give their voice and perspective and to influence the development agenda through UNDP. And so how we envision this working is to have a group of about 17 young people from diverse backgrounds, diverse ages, genders, ethnic backgrounds, making sure we are being as inclusive as possible and looking at issues of people living with disabilities, so that we have a voice that is representative of the young people of Kenya, and we make sure that that voice is being impacted when it comes to the work that UNDP is doing in Kenya. And so we want to see, as we look to the future of development, the programmatic intervention that UNDP is, you know, designing and are in the pipeline, how can we make sure that young people are front and center in the design stage, in the conception stage, and not just as beneficiaries. And so that really is the intention of the Youth Sounding Board.
The inauguration was at the Kenya School of Government, Lower Kabete campus.
We had an event today on the inauguration of the UNDP Youth Sounding Board, where we had the Chief Assistant Secretary, Ministry of ICT, Madam Nadia Abdallah. We also had UNDP Senior Management, Director General of Kenya School of Government, and also the pre-selected Youth Board representative from different sectors in the country, that is the private sector, the NGOs, and also government of Kenya.
CAS Nadia Ahmed, who is a co-chair in the board, explains more about the project.
So we actually leverage and have the opportunity to go through all the programs that UNDP has allocated specifically for young people. Then we now advise them on whether or not these are the programs that will work for them, whether or not this is the particular allocation that is efficient enough and enough for the program development project in the country to be able to help the youth agenda. But also they have aligned themselves with the National Youth Development Policy in order to grow from their programs and to be able to equip young people in Kenya with job opportunities, matters to do with climate change, inclusion of the different gender balances, together with just employment in the country.
In the inclusivity spirit, Ashura represents persons with disability, and being part of this great initiative has renewed a lot of hope.
The UNDP Sounding Board, I'm the only person representing persons with disabilities. From the different the experience and the background that I come from, many times we get worried that persons with disabilities are left behind. How are we going to achieve the SDGs? So this board will give the solutions to the young people in the sector. We'll interact with the young people to give in their ideas so that it can create an impact especially to persons with disabilities. It means as young people, we are ready to take over the leadership and change this country to achieve our goals, especially the SDGs, the Kenya Vision 2030, the Constitution of Kenya. We are ready to support the government of Kenya to achieve its agenda on the youth.
Roy from the National Youth Council envisioned an end where the youth sounding board will be a critical pillar in every agenda.
This is a platform where, as young people, we've been always asking around, when is the young people at the decision table? But this is an opportunity for me, as a youth of this country, amongst other young people, amongst being, of course, the youth sounding board being chaired by our cast, Nadia, just to have a session where young people co-create interventions, programs, and projects for the young people. So we are going to have a lot of fun, we are going to bring a lot of innovations, we're going to bring a lot of creativity, and above all, we are going to make sure that the youth sounding board becomes a critical pillar in the UNDP programming agenda.
CAS Nadia calls for the youth to be on the lookout for this great opportunity, as in line with the great development set out for the country.
Then we are supposed to add between 6 to 7 members. So we are actually cognizant of the fact that we have to show representation, there should be gender balance, of course. So we are really coming up with a structure on how we're going to choose the rest of the board members and what exactly are the code of ethics each and every one of the members who's going to apply will be able to leverage on it. And so far, the different opportunities, we are yet to decide how we're going to disseminate the information so that the young people can apply. And so, this is the first step. So from today, we're going to create the different channels that are there and we're going to progress further. But the young people should really keep an eye on the different social media pages to find out more about the Youth Sounding Board and how they can apply and whether or not they're qualified to sit on that board. One of the real core things that we want to come off out of this Youth Sounding Board is to just bring together the young people and really highlight the patriotism among the young people in Kenya so that they can see that every program that is done is for them, and also so that they can really be patriotic about who they are, where they are, and how they can build on it. So matters to do with climate change, it's an important factor. The president himself is really, really inclined to making sure that everyone plants a tree every day if they can so that we can green our country and be able to plant 2.2 billion trees by 2022. So yes.